My name is Jake Farron. I'm a product designer at a tech company, and I work remote here in my basement. And last year, I thought it'd be a good idea to get a second full-time remote job, kind of to see if it was possible, also to challenge myself, to stretch myself, and to double my income. And so I did it. I pulled it off for 8 months. I was busier than I've ever been in my entire life. In this video, I'm going to talk about the productivity tricks and techniques, the time management rules that I put in place for myself to avoid going absolutely insane. You may have no interest in working two full-time jobs, but I hope this video is helpful if you are working on side projects while maintaining a full-time job, or your job is just super demanding and you've got a family and you're trying to balance a lot of things and being pulled in a lot of directions. So with that, let's jump right into it. I learned very early on that you can only do one thing at a time. You can't multitask. You can only task switch. And even task switching has a cost, so you want to do that as little as possible. But I realized that days would go by and I hadn't made any progress towards anything because I was just totally reacting to, you know, answering a Slack message here, quickly working on a design over here. I actually had two laptops, so I'm bouncing back and forth between them. And I realized that this was not a productive way to get things done. So what I started doing was I would dedicate short bursts of time, like an hour, 2 hours, maybe even the entire morning, to one company. And I would completely ignore the other company. I realized it's amazing what you can accomplish in one solid, focused hour of work. So that's the first lesson. You cannot multitask. You can only task switch. And you want to switch as little as possible because there's a cost to switching back and forth. The next point is also around staying focused, and it has to do with Slack messages and interruptions. I have a tendency to want to get back to people right away. If someone messages me, I want to respond quickly, let them know that I'm available and try to be helpful. I had to learn to just let Slack messages sit there for a while, let emails sit there for a while. If I respond right away, then it kind of messes up the whole flow of what I was doing before. A lot has been written about the effect of interruptions in the workplace. They did the study in UC Irvine where they found that it took on average 25 minutes to get back to the task that you were working on before you were interrupted. So there's this massive cost to getting interrupted. I feel like with email, it's really easy to check your email a couple times a day rather than immediately responding. But Slack is like a messaging app. It's set up just like any other messaging app. So the tendency is even more intense to want to respond right away. So I found that it was incredibly helpful to just put off Slack messages to when it was convenient for me, when I was done with my block of time. This next point is on how I kept track of the tasks that I needed to do. Every week on Sunday night, I would write out all the things that I needed to get done that week in a notebook like this. Things that would make this a great week is like the way that I'm thinking about it. And then every morning before I started the workday, I would write on a sticky note the things that I was hoping to get done that day. I tried a fancy note-taking system. This is a recommendation from Ali Abdal, and it's got a little thing. You can put a card in this piece of paper. This is $80. And then it's like $30 for the subscription to get more of these note cards. And it's pretty cool. I bought it with the remote work, the remote office stipend that I got from one of the companies. So definitely not necessary, but this is what I would use. The problem with this is that the quality is so good, they feel so nice that I feel bad throwing them away. So I actually prefer just sticky notes where I can, crinkle them up, throw them away. But I found it was very effective to keep track of my tasks like that. Otherwise, I'm just completely reactive. I'm just responding to all the things that are coming at me rather than staying out in front of the things that I want to get done. This next point is what I'll call the two mentions rule. So I would hold off on starting on any projects that came to me until it had been brought up multiple times. The first time someone brought something to me, a new project or whatever, I would make a note of it, but I wouldn't start on anything. Because what happens a lot of times is your boss or someone brings a project to you, and then a couple days go by and plans change. Things change, all of a sudden they don't need that anymore. And if you would have started on it back when they first brought it up to you, you would have wasted all that time working on it. So I would always hold off until it was mentioned multiple times and kind of gauge how serious they were about it, and then I would start on it. It's almost guaranteed to happen where people bring an idea to you, they have some request, and then new information comes in, plans change, and then all of a sudden they don't need that anymore. So hold off. The last point is to skip as many meetings as possible. I mean, it's 2022. We all know that meetings are a waste of time, and yet we find ourselves still in endless meetings. So while I was working the two jobs, I did have some schedule conflicts where I had to skip meetings. But if I wasn't needed in the meeting, then I was leaving as quick as possible. And you can always ask someone to message you to come back if they do end up needing you, or they could fill you in after the fact. But meetings will take up your entire day if you let them and keep you from doing any real work. Those are the things that I would do to try to maintain my sanity while I was incredibly busy. If you've ever worked in the corporate world, you know that there's a lot of stuff that doesn't matter. There's a lot of fake work that goes on. I found that the times when I had the most peace of mind, when I was the happiest, the least overwhelmed, was when I was actually getting my work done. When you're working for a company, it's easy to be busy all day, feel like you've worked incredibly hard, but made no progress on the work that actually matters. So I think the main point is get the stuff done that matters the most, get the work done that actually matters, that actually moves the needle, and you'll feel peace of mind and you won't feel overwhelmed. So those are the main things that I learned. Focus on one thing at a time, avoid distractions, and work on the stuff that matters the very most. That's all I got. Thank you for watching. I'll talk to you in the next one. Bye.